Blue Streak was the signature attraction at Conneaut Lake Park. This out-and-back wood coaster was a mainstay at the park for over 80 years, but sadly, it burned down yesterday. In this video, I will discuss the history of Blue Streak and my experience on this historic attraction. Blue Streak opened in 1938. Designed by Edward Vettel, this coaster replaced the park's former scenic railway coaster. Because Blue Streak occupied the same location, it's entirely possible a part of Scenic Railway's wood structure was repurposed for this new ride. Blue Streak had an unconventional track design compared to most wood coasters. Two sections of stacked wood layers were joined by horizontal cross ties. Cyclone at Lakeside Park, which is the last remaining Edward Vettel coaster now, also uses the same track construction. Blue Streak has had a tumultuous history over the past three decades. The park and coaster operated consistently until the 1990s. At that point, Conneaut Lake Park was floundering. The Flynn family owned the park, and they were in debt, so new additions became sparse. And the park made a controversial decision to abandon the free admission policy in favor of gated admission. These two factors led to a decline in attendance. The Flynn family announced a plan to replace the amusement rides, including Blue Streak, which needed nearly $100,000 in repairs, with a new family entertainment complex. But local businessmen who were nostalgic instead purchased the park from Flynn and saved many of the park's classic rides. They invested $1 million into the park, but attendance continued to dwindle and the owners declared bankruptcy in 1995. Conneaut would remain closed for the 1995 season, but Summer Resorts Incorporated and Gary Harris purchased and reopened the park for the 1996 season. However, Blue Streak would not reopen until the 1997 season due to needed repairs. That same year, Harris was convicted of tax evasion and he gave the amusement park back to the community, so Conneaut Lake Park began operating as a non-profit. But the financial troubles continued for the next decade. Conneaut managed to open every single year, even if it was just for a few days, until 2007. Conneaut Lake Park would remain closed for the entire 2007 and 2008 seasons. While the park reopened in 2009, Blue Streak did not. It needed extensive repairs. The park won a $50,000 grant from the Pepsi Refresh Project, and the park raised additional funds to repair Blue Streak so the coaster could reopen for Labor Day weekend in 2010. Blue Streak then operated annually until Conneaut Lake Park was doomed by the COVID-19 pandemic. This was the final nail in the coffin for Blue Streak. Todd Joseph and Keldon Holdens LLC purchased the park for $1.2 million from the trustees of Conneaut Lake Park during a U.S. bankruptcy court hearing. Joseph's plans for the park were centered around concerts and events, not amusement rides. Blue Streak remained closed for the 2021 season, and Joseph said a team of structural engineers would review the coaster's structural integrity later that year to determine if it was worth saving. But I don't think he ever had plans to save the ride. Locals were protesting against Blue Streak being demolished, but yesterday the owners were in the progress of tearing down Blue Streak, possibly without a permit from the news outlets I've seen. And during a controlled burn of the sections of wood that had already been dismantled, a fire spread and engulfed other portions of the ride they had not yet torn down. Joseph now has a permit to demolish what remains of Blue Streak, and it seems like a convenient accident to accomplish his end goal. Unfortunately, the coaster has seemingly had 9 lives, finally saw its demise yesterday. Because of Conneaut's tumultuous future, I made it a priority to visit the park in 2019. And I'm sure glad I did in light of recent events. I was rained out in 2017, but I was able to visit on Memorial Day weekend in 2019. Now, Memorial Day weekend is routinely one of the busiest weekends of the year for amusement parks. For the sake of Conneaut, I was hoping they'd be busy. While the beach attached to Conneaut Lake Park was bustling, the amusement park rides were pretty quiet. And that was even with the park charging just $5 to $10 for wristbands. Most places would be packed to the gills with a deal like that. While I heard Conneaut Lake Park was on the upswing in 2019, at least compared to the prior few seasons, The park still looked dated and dilapidated. Asphalt was cracking. Heck, I saw a guy picking up pieces of asphalt as souvenirs. Blue Streak Station looked like it was on the verge of collapse with its unlevel appearance. But I did love the striking blue sign. It was bright and shiny, unlike everything else with this coaster, and honestly the park. The two crew members working Blue Streak were incredible though. They were some of the nicest employees I've encountered at any park. They were constantly joking and interacting with guests. About a third of their jokes were at the expense of themselves, and the other two-thirds were at the expense of the ride they were working. It was clear Blue Streak was not in the best of condition. The wood had chipped paint and was creaking profusely. However, the ride went out into the woods, and it was a nice setting on ride, and it sort of concealed the ride's appearance. Now, you couldn't hide the classic trains, though. Those NAD trains looked to be in rough shape. The train looked like an ancient relic with the dirt, faded paint, and missing light bulb. However, the trains thankfully rode well as they could in that track. The ride ran a 3-car, 3-bench NAD train seating up to 18 riders, and the seats were super cushiony, and that was much appreciated. As for restraints, you had a comically loose seatbelt that basically wasn't there, and then you had a buzz bar several inches above the lap of most riders. This was ideal for airtime. Now to dispatch the train, the operators need to manually push the train out of the station. That alone is pretty rare nowadays. But I've never seen an operator do this while carrying a drink. I guess they must have some good water in Conneaut. The coaster began with a super slow and bumpy tunnel. When a ride jackhammers this much going just 5 miles per hour, you know you're in for a rough ride. Every single valley was littered with jackhammering, and any change of direction was downright violent. It was clear the ride needed a full retracking. The ride was more tolerable up front, but still bumpy there. And then in the back, the ride was pretty darn brutal. However, I rode it twice in the back because of how insane the airtime was on the outward leg. The airtime was worth the abuse. After cresting the 77-foot or 23-meter-tall lift hill, you traversed an incredible first drop. Here's a play-by-play how ejector airtime works in Blue Streak. The train violently crests the drop. Your body then starts lifting upwards from the negative Gs. Remember, your seatbelt is so loose that you just keep going when you hit it. At the same time, the physical seat you were sitting on starts getting airtime as well. Your thighs then smash into the buzz bar, and a profanity may be yelled. Your butt is then spanked by the seat that had also gotten airtime. Another profanity may be yelled. Both the rider and seat then return to the train together. You then get thrown in a blender in the valley, and at this point a profanity will most likely be yelled. I mean, just look at this transition at the bottom of the first drop. It did not look right, and it really beat you up. I had always heard that Blue Streak's first 3 drops were loaded with ejector airtime, and they sure were. I was basically getting standing airtime considering how minimalistic the restraints were, but you had to ride in the back car to get that airtime. The two camelbacks only offered mild pops of airtime up front. You then rose into the far turnaround. The front would get an abrupt pop of airtime. This would be their strongest, but final bit of airtime. The far turn was slow, but it felt like you were turning on a cobblestone road with how much you shook. You then traversed this gradual drop and twisted upwards to the left. And this transition was the worst in the ride. It had a painful, violent jolt of laterals. You can hear wincing on most POVs here. You then had a relatively straight shot back to the station. It was still bumpy, but the slower speed and lack of turns helped make this better in the comfort department. You had 4 consecutive bunny hills, and they were too slow to offer any airtime up front, but the kinks in the drop offered very faint pops of airtime in the back. You then jumped into the brake run, ending the 2,900-foot, or 880-meter-long coaster. So what would I rate Blue Streak? I would give this coaster a 6 out of 10. Blue Streak was a very flawed ride. Heck, it looked flawed. Anyone could tell this ride was in rough shape, and honestly, it rode even rougher than it looked, if that was even possible. Every time the train changed direction, you were in for a beating. The same could be said on pretty much any valley. However, the ride had some redeeming qualities. For one, it was historic. Two, it had a wonderful setting in the woods. And most importantly, if you rode in the back, you got some of the craziest airtime you could get on any coaster. Those first three drops offered strong airtime, and the way it played out is an experience I will never forget. There were some smaller pops too in the return run, but Blue Streak was all about that first drop and two camelbacks. While I'm sad I'll never get to experience those hills again, the reality was that Blue Streak was too rough for many. It was a one and done for my fiance, and I know plenty of enthusiasts who despise this ride too. I definitely wish this coaster could have gotten a full retracking from someone, but it never seemed likely with the financial struggles that plagued Conneaut over the past three decades. I mean, they were charging $5 and were still struggling to get people to come into the park. So those are my thoughts and a brief history on Blue Streak at Conneaut Lake Park. What are your thoughts on this historic coaster, whether it be about the ride's demise or how it rode? Let me know down in the comments. If you enjoyed this review, I'd appreciate it if you gave this video a like and you considered subscribing, because there'll be a lot more roller coaster amusement park videos here at Canopy Coaster. Thanks for watching.